Dark energy. What the hell is it? Is it an overwhelming cosmic force that makes up the very fabric of our universe and will eventually, potentially, spell the end of all existence, life itself, the sun, the moon, and the stars, yada yada yada? Yes. Well, that was quick. Well, maybe, but is it getting stronger? Also yes, definitely, maybe. But that's the short answer, because the long answer is a much, much more intriguing notion. And if you want to know more about the inner workings of the final boss of all time and space, well, come with me now on this cosmic journey as we figure out the theoretical significance of the cosmological constant. Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, is dark energy getting stronger? Roll the clip.
Where we're going, we won't need eyes to see.
What are you talking about?
I created the event horizon to reach the stars.
Actually, don't worry guys, dark energy isn't really as scary as that, but for the curious amongst you, that clip was from the awesomely underappreciated cosmic space hell horror Event Horizon, and it's actually a fitting motif to set the scene because Sam Neill and Lawrence Fishburne, that's why. It does lead us to an important opening address though, because it's tantamount that we point to the fact that the theory of dark energy is exactly that, just a theory, albeit the most accepted hypotheses to explain the observable expansion of the universe since the 1990s. So if you find yourself having some kind of existential crisis about halfway through this video, don't worry, because the scientific model isn't unscrupulous to change, it's just the best approach that we have right now to figuring out the cosmic secrets of the universe. So, dark energy. We already know that it may indeed be getting stronger, but what exactly is it? Well, the thing is, for eons humanity has stared up at the night sky, and despite mapping the cosmos through the macroscopic scientific art of astronomy, we've always wondered, what the hell is all that space? All the dark stuff that makes up the endless expanse of our observable universe, floating about, doing its thing, being all ominous. The thing is, we don't exactly know what dark energy is for certain, because although it's the most accepted hypothesis that science has to offer, it also seems to contradict most of our understandings about the way the universe works, which is a little bit of a problem, to say the least. Now, science teaches us that all light waves, better known as radiation, carry energy. Every time you step outside on a warm summer's day, you feel that very same energy beating down on your face as you bathe in the glorious wash of our solar overlord. Praise the sun. Now, as we touched on in our black hole video, we know that Einstein's legendary equation, E equals mc squared, teaches us that all matter and energy are interchangeable. They are merely different forms of the exact same thing. And again, we only need to look at our sun to see an example of that. It is powered by the beautiful cosmic conversion of mass to energy. It's really big, and it's really hot, and it's the perfect example of our basic understanding of the universe. But the thing is, energy has to have a source, be it either matter or radiation, as is the interchangeable mechanics of Einstein's equation. And this is where dark energy takes one look at that scrap of paper and flips the damn table over, because when you look at the dark expanse of space, you don't exactly see something, do you? You see nothing. You see the void, the pitch black, the in space no one can hear you scream kind of vibe, right? Because the notion here is that space, despite being devoid of all matter, radiation, life, the kitchen sink, everything, despite all of that, in the understanding of this scientific model, it still has a residual energy. The energy, if you will, of space. Dark energy, which, when considered on a cosmic scale, leads to a force that increases the expansion of the universe. And how or why do we know that? Because we know for certain that the universe is expanding, and it has been ever since the Big Bang. And not only that, but in June 2016, NASA and ESA scientists reported that the universe was actually expanding 5 to 9% faster than we previously thought, thanks to the awesome Hubble Space Telescope. What a useful fella that guy is. Given that, then, it would definitely confirm that dark energy is indeed getting stronger. But how exactly is it powering itself? What's making it grow? If E equals mc squared, where is dark space getting its residual energy from? And this is what makes this question so damn intriguing, because really, in the truest sense of the term, we have no freaking idea. It could be that dark energy is powering itself from the weirdness of quantum mechanics, where in the cosmic realm of the very small, energy and matter appear out of complete nothingness in the briefest, tiniest spark of an instant, like a tiny light switch being infinitely flicked on and off, giving dark space the energy that it needs to expand. It could also be that dark energy is a completely new fundamental force of the universe in itself. We could have gravity, electromagnetism, radiation, and the new guy, dark energy, that came into effect after our universe had or has reached a certain size or age. Theoretically speaking, that model is very much a possibility and could even suggest that the force of dark energy may even be temporary, causing the universe to accelerate for billions of years before it weakens, dissipates, and essentially disappears forever. So long and thanks for all the new space. There's so much room for activities. The truth of the matter is, we just don't know. But the exciting thing is that dark energy may be the unsolved problem that bridges our scientific understanding of the very large and the very small. Einstein's theory of general relativity can explain everything from the inner workings of celestial bodies to the gravitational mechanics of black holes. But when you compare it to quantum mechanics, the two just don't mesh. They don't get on. These two separate schools of physics have gotten us so far in our understanding of the universe, but there's never once been a workable scientific model that ties the two together. Maybe that's where dark energy will step in, because there's one thing that we do know. Dark energy is everywhere. It makes up a staggering 74% of our observable universe, and its effects are only getting stronger as space expands. Eventually, inevitably, such is the course of human history, our observations of the universe will lead to a breakthrough with the cosmological constant and slowly peel back the mystery of just exactly what dark energy is, how it's powering itself, and why the hell it's getting stronger and stronger. Dark energy shows us one thing for certain. It proves that we still have a boatload to learn about the inner workings of our universe, and it will eventually beckon in a brand new scientific age, leading toward a completely unexplored realm of physics. If dark energy can indeed create energy out of nothing, could we? Well, now that's a thought. Dark energy is weird and strange and mysterious, but it's also pretty damn exciting. See? I told you there's nothing to be scared of. Well, there we have it. Our long and short answer to the question is, dark energy getting stronger? Yes. What do you guys think? Why don't you let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below. Before we depart from today's video though, let's take a quick look at some of your more entertaining edifications from over the past few days. First up, Master Tarvos says, what if Jack was a disembodied floating body? Whew, and hell yes, Master Tarvos, now you are talking my kind of language. That's some thinking outside of the box. But what if I was a disenfloated voicing body? Whoa. Next up, Chinadu Opera says, I bet the force is some aspect of dark energy. Whew. You think so? And that's a crossover I was not expecting. Less quantum mechanics and more midichlorians. Well, I never rule out that possibility. On that note, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Cheers for sticking around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button as well as that subscribe button. We'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. And until next time, you take it easy.